Sora 2. The AI video generation behemoth just unveiled by OpenAI. It can create physically realistic, stunning, cinematic footage of incredible length. But it's not open source, censored, and difficult to get an invite code. Today, instead of looking up at the giant, we choose a head-on challenge. My challenge is, can we stitch together a bunch of the latest open source models, running on a PC with only 16GB VRAM and 65GB RAM, to catch up with this Sora 2 monster? Hello everyone, welcome to Smart Vision. This channel focuses on practical, locally runnable AI knowledge and workflows that can help you make money. If you enjoy my videos, please like, share, and subscribe. Your support is my greatest motivation to keep creating. For more downloadable examples and useful workflows, follow my Patreon. Now, let's begin today's episode. For this challenge, I even upgraded my RAM from 32GB to 64GB. Because during testing, I found that OOM out of memory errors were our biggest enemy. In this episode, I will reveal the blueprint for our open source Sora stack and test it against Sora 2's official demos one by one. Ready? Let's begin this ultimate challenge. Let's first look at Sora 2's first demo, a person ice skating with a cat on their head. This video encapsulates Sora 2's four core capabilities: multi-shot coherence, complex physical movement, character consistency, and multimodal integration. To generate this video, it must go through a complex process: LLM deconstructing the prompt, generating the scene, generating the video, generating voice and sound effects, and finally lip syncing. Now we'll use open source models to implement this process. This is our open source Sora stack. Step 1, intelligent deconstruction. We use Ollama to act as the LLM generating image prompts, video prompts, character dialogue, and sound effect prompts based on my description. Step 2, visual foundation. We use Qwen Image and Qwen Image Edit 2509 to generate the scenes for the different shots. Note that Qwen Image Edit 2509 is crucial. It is the key to ensuring our character consistency. Step 3. Character and motion. For standard T2V scenes, we use 1.2.2's T2V or I2V capabilities for generation. But if we need to specify a pose or replace a specific character, we will use the character animation expert 1.2.2 Animate. Step 4. Audio and synthesis. We use Vibe Voice to generate the narration, use 1.2.2 S2V to generate sound effects based on the video content, and finally, synthesize it with lip syncing. Let's return to the first demo, the skater and the cat. We let Ollama generate the video based on the shot prompt. To ensure the skater and the cat look exactly the same across all three shots, we must first use Qwen Image Edit to lock the character ID. And we use 1.2.2 to generate video. Let's compare the results. The video backgrounds generated with the latest open source model are relatively monotonous. This may be because the prompts produced by GPT-OSS aren't good enough. Our goal is to generate everything with models, minimizing manual intervention as much as possible. Also, images generated by Qwen Image Edit 2.579 sometimes fail to meet the prompt requirements. For example, the second scene didn't produce a shot of the character jumping. The video generated with WAN 2.2 also lacks the jumping action. These are deduction points. As for sound effects, they're mediocre overall. The sound in the second scene is unacceptable and contains strange noises, while the sound for the other two scenes is acceptable. Overall, Sora 2 performs very well. The second video shows a person doing a backflip on a skateboard. This video is intended to test the model's physical understanding capabilities. We also generate the video using 1.2.2 with the same prompt. Let's look directly at the result. 1.2.2 was able to generate the person doing a backflip on the river, but the person was wearing a wheeled skateboard on their feet, and the legs looked deformed mid-flip. The sound effects were also poor. It seems WAN 2.2 had difficulty understanding this prompt. The third video shows a person standing on two horses. This scene had no storyboard, so I generated it directly using this prompt. Let's look directly at the result. 1.2 did not understand the prompt and generated the wrong scene, but the sound effects sounded acceptable. Sora 2 completely won this scene. The fourth video is a Japanese anime scene, with very detailed prompts written below the video. So, there's no need to write overly detailed prompts. Then, based on this prompt, we generate the image prompts, video prompts, character dialogue, and sound effects for several scenes. Based on the results, Twingnamu's edit cannot successfully generate the images because it fails to understand the character names in the prompt. You need to pre-generate character images first, so it can't produce this sequence from a single prompt. In this respect, Sora 2 completely wins. The fifth video is a scene where a dog floats in space, enters a spaceship, and tries to catch a tennis ball. I directly use Ollama to generate the prompt. Based on this prompt, generate image prompts, video prompts, character dialogue, and sound effect prompts for several scenes. Judge from the results, Qwen Image Edit 2509 couldn't successfully generate images for the different scenes. It only made slight modifications to the original images. On the audio side, because the setting is space, the AI model either doesn't generate sound at all, or only produces a little. It still seems accurate. The sixth video shows a man doing three consecutive backflips. The scene has no separate shots, so I directly generated it using this prompt in WAN 2.2. This scene is still pretty good, not worse than Sora 2. The seventh video shows a female gymnast jumping on a vaulting horse. The scene has no separate shots, so I directly generated it using this prompt in WAN 2.2. This scene doesn't have as much dynamism as Sora 2's. The whole scene only has the person jump, and the movement is a bit unnatural. The background looks static. The eighth video shows a man jumping into an outdoor swimming pool. The scene also has no separate shots, so I directly generated it using this prompt and WAN 2.2. What is this? The ninth video is a rather humorous scene. A man riding a horse, and that horse is also riding another horse. The scene also has no separate shots, so I directly generated it using this prompt and WAN 2.2. Okay, WAN 2.2 doesn't understand the prompt. The 10th video is a multi-person scene. A group of people playing beach volleyball, and the video length is quite long. The scene also has no separate shots, so I directly generated it using this prompt and WAN 2.2. This scene's character movement is quite natural, and the camera also tracks the ball. However, the people all look a bit similar, and the ball disappears while in the air, which is unfortunate. The 11th video is a person skateboarding. Oh my god, is he in space? The 12th video is a spotted dog playing on an Italian street. Similarly, I directly used WAN 2.2 T2V to generate it. Okay, this is a sci-fi movie. Dog literally duplicated itself. Sora 2 remains the undisputed champion in large-scale physical simulation, multi-character coherence, and complex storyboard transitions. Open source models still need further development, especially improvements in automatic storyboard generation, before they can catch up with Sora 2. This video was just a simple comparison test for entertainment purposes. Comments are welcome. Alright, let's continue looking at the workflow. First, this group uses Ollama to generate prompts for scenes, animation, and sound. Here we set the role for each local model. For example, this one is the director who specifically writes storyboard prompts for generating images. This one is the director who specifically writes video description prompts for generating video descriptions. The second group is the module for Qwen to generate image edits. Enter the image generation prompts here. If you want to maintain character consistency, you can use this module, Qwen Image Edit 2509, to regenerate character scenes. After making your selections, just run it. The third group is for generating video, including image to video and text to video. Here I'm using WAN 2.2 I2V. import images, or enter text. Just run it. The fourth GUI generates sound and audio and does lip syncing. Here, input the audio file you want to clone. Choose the model type. I've already selected it here. After selecting, just run it. For lip syncing, I use 1.2.2 here. Import the audio file and the video file. Just run it. Finally, if you want to make images or videos high resolution, you can refer to my video, which introduces three workflows for batch upscaling images and videos and shows how to obtain the related workflow. I've uploaded the ComfyUI workflow JSON file and usage instructions to my Patreon for you to download. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to my channel. I'm Smart Vision. See you next time.